out wherever I'm at. I think I'm at the top right now, and I owe it all to Buddy Atkins Sr. Zachary Fleming. Well, of course, Sandy Dunn proving there that she can do it on a jam, but when she first broke in with the old Brooklyn Red Devils, Kent Motti used her quickly on defense at the back. Buddy Atkinson insisted to put her out and let her do a little jamming, too.
Yeah, Buddy had a knack for kicking out jammers. A blocker who could jam or go both ways. Sandy was one of the jammers, and Buddy had a great eye for that, picking up that talent that could go both ways.
Well, Peanuts Meyer, River Williams, picks it up on this one. Meyer all over the lead. Back with an elbow. Winners get Sandy Dunn scored the first Grand Slam five-pointer of the game. Pioneers lead at 35-32. Now the Bombers would like to pick some of that up. Williams back on defense for the Pioneers right now. Joni Weston back to assist. A whip out of the turn. Peanuts into a block by Sandy Dunn back to block. Now Williams back. Meyer inside. And she has got one. Williams does not know yet that Meyer is Meyer. Trying to move on Sandy Dunn. Here comes Weston on the inside. Myers put it out. The horn sounds. It's jam over. Look out. Weston and Dunn on the rail. Myers sent over the rail. The word. Two bomber points. Here's Meyer back on his skates. We have Williams back on his skates. Here's Meyer getting back on the track. A wild one there. Carol Peanutz Meyer scoring. Let's watch this again on replay. Here's Weston for the second point. Meyer just kind of spins through the inside.
That's one of the few times that you see a skater using their hands. There's only another time. Whenever somebody's giving a whip, you can use your hands. Or if somebody's on your own team and you want to whip them around that way, you can also use your hands. Any other time, if you see opposing skaters using hands on one another, they would get a penalty. But since Joan Weston and Peanuts Meyer are on the same team, she used her hands, she grabbed her, pulled her around Sandy, and wasn't penalized because it was one of her own members.
Boy, and they are having a problem down here on the infield. Now Sandy Dunn is trying to cover him. Right on his feet here. He's going to go to the corner. Sandy Dunn is going to move. And everybody get into it. If they're not get there, they're going to be
looks like it. The same thing happened earlier. For some reason, the Bombers cannot fight one-on-one. Right there, Delores Tucker was going at it with Sandy Dunn, and there was Joan Weston. Two Bombers against one opposing skater. It happens all the time. It happens with Bill Grohl and Cliff Butler. That's one thing I think they have to learn. You know, if it's going to be one-on-one, why don't they just fight one-on-one? The Bombers are such a tight team, I guess, that they have to fight more than one at a time.
Well, time has run out here at the end of the seventh period, final women's period of action. The score stands. The Midwest Pioneers, 35. The Bay Bombers, 34. And we will pause along the IRSL network.